Hey everyone, this is YoshiRider123 and welcome back to our Let's Play of Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga. Now, recent events, we didn't really progress much, but that was basically because we were doing these side quests minigames thing for TVs. So we're actually going to progress in the story right now in this video. Yeah, so now you see the Hammerhead Brothers, and like the Starshade Brothers, they apparently forgotten that we can use our new abilities in battle. So let's check it out. Yeah, we know, Mario uses A, and Luigi uses B. Now that was unnecessary. So, using your hammer, in this case, would be a solo attack, like the jump command. So, from now on, when you use the solo command, another menu pops up and asks you if you want to use jump or hammer. So you choose hammer and select your enemy. Now, to successfully execute your hammer attack, you have to press A right when you start shaking, which is usually pretty quick. So don't worry if you have to wait a while, because it happens pretty quick. You know, it'll just feel like nothing. And that's how solo hammer actions work in the battle. And oh yeah, and defending. So far we've only been defending ourselves by jumping, but there are enemy moves that we'll need to be using our hammers, so this is a good explanation. We have to hold down the B button, and you have to, you have to let go of B when the hammer starts shaking. And with the hammer, you have to knock back whatever is coming at you. Like that. That's how it should have been. Yeah, using your hammer is pretty hefty in defending. You have to hold the button long enough, so you have to time yourself. No. There is an item in the game that lets you have infinite hammer time. Well, that's a pretty bad way to call it. No, I should probably rephrase that. You won't have like a time. No, that's not how you phrase it. You'll never drop your hammer. That's what I should have said. With this one item that if you equip, you won't drop your hammer, no matter how long you hold it. So if you're bad at the hammer, you'll probably want that. Yes, that's a... I thought that was an interesting joke. Suspenders instead of suspense. Oh dear. Yeah. We can't get through here until later in the game. We'll be down there in a sec. Let's go up here north and see what's up. Blocks. A syrup. Mushroom. Rose block. Oh, right, about this thing. You can see that it's a boost statue, but we won't be able to do anything with this just yet. We can't do anything because whenever we look at it, it goes away. So nothing we have at the moment will let us interact with it. So we'll just have to come back later. Let's go to the west. Now, I'm not gonna go over this cliff right here because this actually leads to the dead end that I talked about in the other video. And if we go down here, we have to go to the minecart challenge again. So no. We're back here. Let's go south. As you notice, the background music changed. Let's check our map and see where we are. We're now at NW Beanbean, which is short for Northwest Beanbean. We're at the northwest region of the Beanbean Kingdom, and as you can see, we're supposed to be on our way to the Beanbean Castle town. Now, there's actually a lot of freedom at this point. You can actually go around the whole Beanbean region right here in the center, but we're not going to because there are some pretty tough enemies, so we'll just go to where we have to. Nothing here. Hammer. This is a spike enemy, so we won't be jumping on it. Ah, I rammed into it too fast. Now these are sharpies. Ah. You don't jump on these guys, as you can probably tell. Ah. Okay. Now, if you strike an enemy on the field with the hammer, you have a good chance of paralyzing all enemies on the field, or at least most of them. So remember that. It doesn't actually harm the enemies though, it just paralyzes them. And they won't be able to strike until I think their next turn or the turn after that. And it helps. So remember, if you want to deal damage right away, you'll jump on them, unless you can't. Or if you want to paralyze them and get a head start, use your hammer. And if you notice, the battle victory screen is different if you use the hammers to end the match than your jumps. There's also another one, but we'll go over that later. Oh my goodness, Mario's bad at this. Okay, nothing else here. So Beanbean Castle Town is a little bit south, so let's go south. Enemy. We can either jump on or strike with the hammer. These are swarms, I think as you pronounce it, swarm. I'm not really sure what these are actually, but they basically attack by going underground and striking when they get up close to you. And they're a little tougher to beat than the sharpies. Okay. Did we miss anything? No. Probably have an easier time attacking the swarms with the hammer rather than the jump. Chop. You'll know who the swarm will attack if you notice that the earth that rises up next to the brother, so it's not that hard to tell. Dang, I missed. Yeah, there are a lot of enemies on the way to the castle town. The sharpies have pretty obvious attacks. They don't really have anything to vary. We can't get through this part yet, so let's just go back. Another battle, two swarms, and a sharpie. Now this worm, it attacks two ways. The one you just saw so far was with, by going underground and striking right in front of you, but they can also, make you use your jump attack like that. So we're gonna end the episode here, everyone. Thanks for watching. This has been YoshiRider123 with our Let's Play of Mario & Luigi Superstar Saga Without Healing. And I'll see you guys next time for more. So yeah. See you later, guys. Yeah. And good night. Ciao.